කරන ටෝච් එකක් හොයාගනින් කියලා.
ඒ හරි ඉතින් තිබ්බගෙන ගෙනා බැටරි ටික ඉවර නැහැ කියලා මම නොකරන්න.
ඉතින් දැන් ගිහිල්ලා බැටරි ගන්නද කියන්නේ දැන් කඩවල ඔක්කොම වහලා තියෙන්නේ.
So you saw the disadvantages of the normal torch. We have the alternative solution for that. Rechargeable torch. So let's look into it.
It has a blue plastic body, a black head. It contains 6 LEDs and 1 halogen bulb. They have used a little bit aesthetics here. They have included hearts. This red button is easily identified. The charging port is situated here. Although it is heavy, it has a good grip. Let's dismantle this and see what is inside.
Please dismantle this. It's too tight now.
Look at this battery. This is why it's so heavy. I think this bar has been used to hold this battery. Let's remove this bar. Oh my goodness.
Let's talk about this battery. This is a lead battery, 6.5 ampere hours. So basically, halogen bulb draws minimum 1 ampere. So this may be used to drive that one. So let's analyze the circuit.
Huh, look at this circuit.
Here we can see 4017 Johnson decay counter and a high power transistor and some other transistors, capacitors, resistors. We can see a Zener diode and some other normal diodes, and there are some capacitors as well. Let's see what is happening inside this.
We have analyzed the circuit, so we obtained this schematic diagram. Let's go through this. V supply denoted here is the voltage supply that comes from the charger, which will come to the circuit through this wire. V battery denoted here is the voltage supply that comes from the battery, which comes through the circuit through this wire. This push button is situated here, which will give the IC clock pulses. The IC is CD4017. This IC is a decade counter, so it counts from 0 to 9. Pin number 3 will be the output 0, and then pin number 2, 4, 7, 10 and 1 will be the output 5. When it comes to 5, it will be connected to the reset and it will give a pulse to the reset. So the entire system will reset. Pin number 7 is connected to a multivibrator, and then pin number 2 will also be connected to another multivibrator. This transistor, which is a high power transistor which can draw a lot of current, is connected to the halogen bulb. This transistor here is connected to the 6 LEDs. Here you can see a voltage regulator circuit connected to the pin number 15 and to the voltage supply. We will move on to the functionality of this.
The function of the torch can be explained by using a pentagram. At first, the torch will be switched off. Next, the torch will be blinked. The torch will have the highest intensity. The halogen will be dimmed.
So this block diagram here explains you the entire functionality of the torch. Here you can see it is divided into two main parts. The first part is the power supply part. Here you can see a voltage regulator. This voltage regulator does two main things. When you connect the external power supply it will disconnect the entire control unit. And the next thing is that when the battery reduces less than 4 volts, it will also again disconnect the entire control system and it will save the battery. Okay.
When the battery is connected, this PNP transistor is biased and the halogen will also lighten up. When the voltage between these two knobs is above 4.3 volts, this NPN transistor is biased. If it is below than 4.3 volts, due to this zener, this transistor will not bias and this reset pin is pulled up.
This control unit is controlled by this push button. When you press it once, it will connect to this 0.8 Hz oscillator. So the halogen lamp will be blinked. Then when you press it again, it will directly connect to this halogen lamp. So the halogen lamp will have its maximum brightness. Then when you press it again, it will connect to this 216 Hz oscillator. So the halogen lamp will be dimmed. Then again when you press this button, it will connect to this LED. After that, when you press the button, the entire system will be turned off. So let us have an explanation of this oscillator, which is a multivibrator.
We can find this type of multivibrator circuit inside our couch. We have two equal resistors here and two equal capacitors. When we give an input, we will get a square pulse as an output. The frequency of this square pulse will be depend on this R and C. That means this resistor and this capacitor values. This has to be equal. Peace.